would describe myself, first and foremost, a figurative sculptor. So I've done that from the very beginning, starting in art school, working basically from direct observation with a living model. And concurrently, I also worked for a number of years in the film industry, which also informed my practice significantly, and in fact, I think is a key element in my current work. I regard myself as an ambivalent portraitist, and it's in part because I'm more interested in the question of observation, maybe the question of identity, than to try and, you know, kind of affirm or assert. All of the projects need to connect in some way to our relationship to the image world that we live in. So each project kind of tackles that a little differently. The first piece that challenged this territory was Elfo. And when you look at that piece, you'll notice it's even cropped to look like a photograph. The shoulders are cut off, it's flat along the bottom. So from the front, it could be very much, you know, if you saw it with a frame around it, you would think you're looking at a photograph. And it was with that piece that I was kind of working out all these basic ideas. With Murray, as the viewer walks around the piece, the viewer will notice that it's compressed. Viewed straight on, you can either assume it's a fully formed sculpture, or if you're far enough away, you might even have a kind of feeling that it's kind of photographic. As one gets closer, it becomes more apparent that it's sculptural. Then as you move around it, it compresses again. So that one is kind of based on a relationship that we have to photography and viewing things frontally. Shelley is, in a way, doing a similar thing. She's facing away from the viewer, so she's basically facing the wall. But the closer the sculpture gets to the wall, the flatter it gets. So even though you can look around the back of it and still see shape, the shape on the back is flattened. So it's almost as though, if you're thinking in perspective, that the wall represents zero, and then the front represents full volume, and somewhere in between, you go from full volume to flatness. The stretch project kind of refers to, you know, the advent in a way of Photoshop, digital media, and the ability to manipulate images. The backs, it probably has more to do with the extent to which we identify each other through key sort of signifiers like the eyes, the mouth. So the backs have no face. They have the promise of a face, and as you move around, they get flatter and flatter, and the closer you get to the face, the more it's sort of taken away. So you never get to see a face, but you get to see this very complex object, and one that's describing an individual in fairly specific detail. With this self-portrait series, I think I did delve much more deeply and more personally into this kind of the ambiguity and the uncertainty of the image, this kind of unreliability of the image. Because in both cases, I'm actually starting from what I look like now, not from what I used to look like. So they're both, the young and the old, are still a reflection in some way on how I look now. And I think just conceptually that's, for me, to the point. Like, no matter how we think we used to look, that information is not clear and it's unreliable, and it's all just a reflection on how we feel and imagine now. Generally, the sculpting process for me is this really prolonged process of acute observation and trying to understand the complexities of shapes and how they go together. I would start modeling in clay, often from direct observation from a living subject or maybe from imagination. Once the clay sculpture was complete, then I would make a mold and cast the clay into a more permanent material. And in my case, I cast into silicone. which is what allows for the color and for the implantation of the hair and the, you know, the, that kind of added realistic effect. In a way, there's many crafts and many aspects to the process that one has to kind of master or pull together. So maybe that's the hardest thing of all, is to make sure that all of those things are up to a certain standard so that ultimately at the end they'll all come together and there won't be one part of it that's so obviously weaker that you're not convinced. You know, with every time out, you're trying to challenge yourself to kind of just push that boundary a little bit more. But it's hard for me to say, you know, what the big quest is at this point. I think it's to continue with the project and to hopefully, you know, continue to have interesting things to say.